Yeah, so first and foremost, I think the what many younger men, they are something they're lacking, and the lack of it creates unhappiness. So they lack direction, they lack goals, they lack something to strive for. So they go around not really knowing what to aim for. So they take every day as it is. But I understand now that the lack of adventure, the lack of struggle, the lack of a higher goal to strive towards, it's making them unhappy. So therefore they compensate by doing a lot of different things. It might be drugs, it might be excessive video game playing, or it might be something that isn't really congruent with a long-term happiness. So when you have the quest for physical excellence, it might be getting better at Thai boxing, it might be getting physically more muscular, it might be even if you have someone who's running in the forest, he might want to get a better time, a time around a lap, for example. As long as you have something to strive towards, you will have that sense of being on a quest, and that will be, you know, will give purpose to you. So that is actually one of the first things I understood when I looked upon other young men over, yeah, this last 10 years. I saw they are, you know, something is missing, and I think that is it. And you don't really see it with men who have their own companies. They have that drive, they have that fire, but for a lot of, especially young men, when they don't have that, when they're just drifting, I think a lot of unhappiness and other detrimental behaviors come from it. And in regards to the discipline aspect, when you start going to the gym, for example, it's like a big piece of the puzzle is being placed, and then smaller pieces are being placed there as well, such as sleep. When you train hard, it can be Thai boxing, or it can be the gym, or wrestling, or whatever it might be. When you understand that you need a complete puzzle, and sleep is an integral part there as well, that will come into play. Then you understand, okay, diet is a good way. So automatically, when you start seeing results in the gym, when you start seeing that, oh, can I optimize this? Can I get better by adjusting lifestyle factors? Then you start putting all of these pieces into place. So that's where a good place to start with discipline, I'd say, it's when you understand that through discipline, you will get so many benefits. And when you get that taste of, success in the gym, or in when you learn new stuff in a martial arts or whatever it might be, when you get those small victories, the discipline will come much easier, because then you see a direct reward of it. So I'd say usually I give the gym as a good starting point, because then a lot of different things will fall into place naturally.
In fact, having good physical exercise and fitness is a way to provoke endorphins and hormones that makes you feel good. And it's one of the best ways to get out of depression. And especially these times where there is a lot of young people, especially, who cannot get out, they cannot party. And this is a young people thing. They get depressed. They don't see a future, because there's no horizon out of what has been happening for a year and a half. I cannot even mention, because otherwise we get striked. And definitely sport, going running, going fighting, going, even if you have to do it in your room, pull-ups and so on, and everything, squats and whatever you need to do on your own, will make you feel better. But of course the discipline is hard. So looking at videos on the internet of training and finding perhaps, how do you say, role models, people who, like you, for a lot of young people and others can. When I was a kid, I used to like watch Arnold Schwarzenegger pumping iron, and I never went to big muscle development, but certainly the discipline that was required was fascinating to me.